Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Lunar Eternal Blue Blind, episode 101. Holy crap, I had no idea the game was going to be this long. We're in the epilogue stages. We're gonna get Gene this episode, because I just did a little reconnaissance, and I found out where the carnival is. It's not far from here at all, so once I found it, I said, okay, time to begin recording, and restored my game from here, from where we left off last episode. So we need to get her back in the party, and I've received an anonymous tip of where I can find Leo. Oh, you're doomed. We went back in time and erased your existence. You were never born. That's how thoroughly we destroyed you. Hurrah! See, it was that hard? When our world teetered on the brink of destruction, I thought the show was over. But now that the world has been saved, I know that the show must go on. So come on in, enjoy the carnival, and forget your worries. Now, there's no one on the side of us, all this stuff, right? Going off the map here. It's stuck in trees. Apparently, those people hanging out over here. Say there, looks like you need an escort, honey pie. Come here, I'll take real good care of you. Come any closer and I'll take permanent care of you, freak boy. I know you're kind, so just keep your distance. Okay, one's too friendly and one's not friendly at all. Let's go say hi to the circus. And ultimately, Gene. I heard from Gene that you are a real red dragon. Will you show me the way you spout flame, please? Sorry, I'm an adult now. To show off just for you would be childish. Oh, that's so depressing. I was looking forward to seeing you spew fire. Look one and all upon the face of an oddity, a human flamethrower. Please turn away if you have a weak stomach. He will spew flame from his mouth. Grandpa will get in trouble if my mommy and daddy find out about this. Daddy will be real mad. The last time Grandpa took me, he left me at the store. I think he's getting too old to go places by himself. Say, lady, you look like a magic performer. Can you make Grandpa come back? Is this Grandpa? Grandpa, if you don't start remembering better, Mommy and Daddy are going to put you away in a home. I heard him say that. Like, oh, that's horrible. Oh, I remember now. I went and got that crazy kid from her parents in Larpa. Promised to show her the sights of the carnival. I must have forgot all about her once I got here. I wonder where she went. Come one, come all. There's always a new game starting in the Hall of Chance. My dice are red hot, Ronfra says. I've got to take another crack at the games in there. I can double my money in just a few minutes. Ronfra, Ruby says, I think you're using a lifetime's worth of luck tonight. You better quit while you're ahead. You really know how to drag a guy down, don't you? Say there, come on over and try your luck with the bones. If you win, you win big, and if you lose, so what? You can play again. Alright. Ah, just like what I like to see. Someone who can take control of their destiny. Well then, mister, you won't mind if I ensure my destiny by checking your dice. Oh, no, no, that's not necessary. We're a licensed establishment. There's no cheating here. Okay, folks, what will you wager? 50. 50 silver it is. I like a person that's willing to risk a little. Okay, we're all set to play wings and thighs. You just need to pick one. Take wings. Wings are even, thighs are odd. What do you want to bet on, wings or thighs? I'll take wings. Okay, you chose wings. Let's roll them bones. Wings! You won. Take your money. Another round? No thanks. Shouldn't leave the table until you give me a chance to get my money back. Let's try for 10,000. Hero, betting 10,000 silver seems kind of reckless, Ruby says. I hope you know what you're doing. Okay, then, we've got some serious action rolling here. Folks, gather around. Wings. Dies, you lost. Better luck next time. Again. Wings again. Thighs. Alright, thighs. Are you serious? One more time. And we don't have anything else to use the money on, other than some silver lights. One more time. Gotta win once. Wings. Still got over 100,000. I don't know, I wonder if it was rigged. I asked a fortune teller to see my romantic future again. She said that the stars had changed and I might meet a cool guy here. Well, it's not Hero, Ruby says. Hero's already taken. Did Ruby say that back then? Because now, Hero's taken by Lucia. If you've lost something or need to find a thing, come here. The fortune teller is very accurate and she doesn't charge $3.95 a minute. I've been expecting you. Come in, take a seat, and let me tell your fortune. To the southwest point, there is something of value. To the south, I see water, sand, dragon. To the west, I see ocean, white, tower. These images I see in my head must have some basis in reality. Why not search for them, as I have said? If you need more help, return to me. After my wife died, I used this song to keep her alive in my heart. She was my one and only love. Her passing was a great loss to me. But I don't cry anymore, because we are still as one, joined in a love that is eternal. Oh, dude. I heard a rumor that this cat is really the actual Red Dragon. If that's true, 1 week in the sideshow and we'd all be able to retire. No, 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 Ruby says. I will not let you put me on display like some animal. But Ruby, you are an animal, Lumina says, in a weird sort of way. Why not turn that gift into hard cash for all of us? You know, a gift that keeps on giving. Is this that mirror place? Or that dark place? No. I wonder if this piece will last until the next carnival. I sure hope so. Hi there, welcome to Bunny's Item Shop. You don't have what I want. I wasn't aware this was an item shop. Oh, I see it on the top there. Say, why don't you buy some of my colorful balloons? If you buy a whole lot, they'll lift you into the sky. Ruby says, I'm not some stupid kid you can sucker in with that tired sales pitch, but I will take just one. Jean's dancing is the best in the land. After she came back, the carnival business went through the roof. People came from as far away as Dalton to see her dance. If you make me mess up this song, my daughter is going to be mad. So just don't talk to me, okay? La 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 la. Sight to my eyes and warmth to my heart. La 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 la. Excuse me. Say, Hero. Ruby says, isn't this the song Lucia really liked? Something about... Your love eternal shall be destiny. Our love eternal shall be destiny. Dad, come on, we've got to go. Gene's the next one up to dance. People say it's amazing, and I don't want to miss it. Say, hick, let's go see that cutie Gene shake her booty, huh? Huh? Hick. But wait a minute while I finish this drink. Be careful not to order two different tonics. Some combinations will knock you on your butt. I'm forgetting, did I go in here? Oh. Yeah, I don't know what the deal is with that. There's Gene. Let's go talk to everyone else first. J42 to J37. The black wire then crosses over and hooks onto yellow J29. Yikes. Geez, don't just walk up and scare me like that. I'm working hard to finish the new magic arrow so you guys can fly in it. Say, you don't know anyone that would like to take a magic arrow ride? I need a guinea pig, I mean to say volunteer, to try it out. After one lesson of karate with Jean, I stopped taking lessons from her. I got tired of her kicking the snot out of me. I think I'll stick to dancing. I've been dancing my legs off, and all I keep hearing is how great Jean is. Don't walk away from me, Jean. We have a score to settle. With all the traveling I've done, I got some pretty cool stuff. I buy and sell almost everything. What can I do for you? Nothing. Probably. Yeah, nothing. I give, and it's just not good enough for you people. What more do you want from me? Just go. I'll never be good enough for you anyway. Leave me. Jeez, what's his issue? There once was a girl from Nantucket. Do you have any plans to ride the magic arrow again? I mean, after you stop looking greenish. It's gone. Guy's working on it, I guess. But... That's where, Lucia got her new outfit. My love Jean keeps coming back here to be near me. I know that a secret flame burns in her heart for me and me alone. I'm glad Jean's back now, but I also worry that she's become a better dancer. Oh no, what will happen to me if she has improved her dance skills? I'll be dead meat. No one will want to see me dance. Okay, so it's like you've been worrying the whole time and then you go, oh no, like you just realized. It's so cool that Jean has come back. She teaches me karate every day after she finishes her dance. Pretty soon I'll be big and strong enough to protect everyone in the carnival. Everyone is singing and dancing because the world is at peace. We owe you our eternal gratitude, hero. Hi, Jean. You came back, just like you promised. Ruby says, Jean, I always thought you looked best dressed as a dancer. Thanks, Ruby. I like being a dancer. Say, where's Lucia? After all, I did promise her that I would do a dance for her once we defeated Zophar. What's wrong with Hero? His eyes seem so distant, so lost. What? Lucia went back to the Blue Star without Hero? Hero, are you sure you want to go to the Blue Star? Well, you know you could always count on me. Do you want my help? Nah, I can do it myself. Okay, if that's how you feel, Hero, but I'm ready to help anytime. After all, you helped me defeat Lun and put an end to the Blue Dragon cult. Come on, let me help you. Hero, stop your complaining. I already told you I'm willing to help. Are you just going to sit there and act stupid? Do you want my help or not? Yes, Jean, I need your help. Alright, this is going to be just like old times. Excuse me while I go put on something a little bit more appropriate. Hey, there you go. Guess I shouldn't have said I'd never use karate again, huh? But this is kind of a special case. We've got to find a way for you to get back to the Blue Star. Jean's back. Evidently the game doesn't like to give him back with all their mana. Okay, so she's got apparently the same stuff as before. Jean, are you leaving again? I have to. My friends need my help. You have always placed others' well-being ahead of your own. I hope your friends realize all the sacrifices you have made for them. Well, hurry back. You know that you are always welcome here. Gene, don't forget that this is carnival is your home and we are your family. Gibbon, relax. I'm not going off to get killed or something. I'll be back before you even have a chance to start missing me. Oh, sorry. I've told you a million times, we're not going to fly on your magic arrows. Ever. Gene, are you going back on the road with your friends? Yeah, it's time that we finally bring an end to this chapter of Hero's life. Gene, have you finally returned to dance? It's about time we see who is the best dancer is in this carnival. No, I'm just getting ready to leave again. I'll see you later. Which is the guy who sells... Oh, that's him. Let's see if these people have anything else to say. Gene, sweet Gene, why do you let our love run cold? I will love you until the end of time, and yet my love goes unrequited. You know, you'd be a lot happier if you just fixated on someone you could get, Gene says. Gene, these days your face is always flushed. Are you sick? I think I may be lovesick. You don't say. For who? I'll keep practicing the things you taught me, Gene. Keep it up. You're going to be very strong someday. Now, didn't she say that Lucia's very lucky, but she's not going to hold it against her, something like that? Alright, we got jeans. Get the hell out of here. Now, we need to make our way to the Mystic Ruins. And that's not it. Okay, relay that order. I went all the way around there, found my way through those up and down the mountains. I forgot. It just leads back to that haunted mansion, or haunted manor, or whatever it is, that where we first met Lamina, and she put us through this test. So, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to find whatever that ice town is. I forget the name of it. Zulan, I believe the name is. So, I made my way all the way back through the Illusion Woods and stuff, which is a pain in the butt. But I found my way better than last time. Okay, this way is Dalton. Let's see if you find a way to Zulan, and you could also find your way to that desert town that I always forget the name of as well. This way. Then we're going to come across Maribia, which is that. And we're going to pass it right by. Because we just were there a couple episodes ago. Now, luckily, you'd think we can't go, but we can. It keeps sticking, though. I think this is where Zulan is up here. If you want a little bit of perspective, here. We just save here so I don't have to go all the way back. Blah. I hate that. believe it's through here. Yeah. There's... We were able to go right through, see that? That puts a whole different perspective on things. I didn't know we could bring the ship through like that. Let's go to Zulan and we'll be back. Just bothers me, although I can't remember the name of this place. I don't even know if they say it. It's east and west something or other. Ah, it's gonna be killing me now. I had no friggin' idea. I ran into it. Did I crash the game? Okay. So that helps a lot. That opens up territory to us now that we can get to that I didn't think we could. Up here is Zulan. Fortunately, if you bring your ship up there, the game keeps putting us in a spot in which we can't even there. Ah, see? It keeps doing that. Okay, just put us to the right of the ship. Can you do that? Thank you. I mean the left. You know what I meant. Because it won't make it through all the way here. I just want to see if they have anything new to say, these people. Fatal for you, maybe. All the way up and around. Hello, I just love talking to people like you. I would like to take this opportunity to welcome you to our village. Is that nice enough for you? Damn little kids, don't you know you don't have any right to criticize my talk? I got your scrawny little butts out of here before I throw you out. I didn't say anything. You know, there's this nice guy named Ramus that wants to turn this place into a nice little tourist trap. By tripling our prices, we'll really rake in the dough. Lamina says, I knew Ramus would go to any lengths to win our little bet. But this is really too much. I can't imagine being married to that dweeb. I heard that the battle for our world was almost lost. That would have been terrible. Yes, it would have. When all the snow melts, I'm going to sell it as mineral water. I'll call it Zulan Magic Tonic. I know it'll be a big hit. Ruby says, who would want to buy water that came from snow? And besides, isn't most of the snow around here yellow? Shut up, Ruby, Lamina says. Listen, I know a place where we could sell a million of these. Say there, sir, would you like to sign this distribution agreement? Man, Lamina, don't you ever stop trying to spin gold for manure? I've already made my plans to get out of this place, and thanks to you, the path out of here is safe. With the heat wave we're having, they closed down the ski operations. Man, I wish that monster was still alive. At least we could still ski. Due to the warm weather, we've started to plant our gardens. This is going to be a great year for botanists. Alright, so there's just one way, right? In. Now that the work in the fields has started, my man has gone all day long. At least if there was snow, he'd be able to stay around the house. Now that the weather is good, I have to work hard so we'll have food next winter. I don't want a repeat of last year's tight food supply. No siree. Howdy! You want to play Pin the Monster Head on the Ugly Boy? So what if it isn't nice? At least it's a fun game to play. I hated playing that stupid game of being trapped on the icy snow pass. Next time I get to be the guy that survives. The mayor is upstairs working on his plans to turn Zulan into a resort. It all sounds very glamorous to me. I'm so happy to know that there are people in this world like you. Not only did you save my girlfriend, but you saved the world too. Do you think the power of love is strong enough to safeguard us forever? I don't know about forever, Ruby says, but it sure makes for a nice start. Oops. I had a dream last night. You and Lucia were in it. I dreamt that Lucia was in a place colder than this, and somehow you found a way to be with her. Crazy, huh? As usual, Hero is speechless. My husband finally returned last night. He's so grateful for what you've done. I want to thank you for saving my daughter's life. Words cannot express how happy I am. Just seeing her laugh brings me great joy. I just don't know what I would have done if she'd died. But thanks to you, I don't have to think about that. We're really starting to turn this village around. Ramus was here yesterday, and he said we should make this place into a resort. I don't want to hear how great you guys think you are. We both know who killed that monster. Ruby says, if you killed it, it was because it died laughing at you, you sorry excuse for a man. If I could have killed that beast, I would have ripped his spleen out with my teeth. If it had a spleen. My wounds are finally healing. The doc says I should be out of here in a couple days. Now that spring is here, everyone is in a better mood. Don't you agree? Like, maybe they're in a mood to donate to the Magic Guild? No. Okay. I know there's another way out. I just want to start off from where I was. Man, oh man, I just can't wait till this summer. The bods, the studs, the sun. Wow. Okay, let's heal Lamina's little magic here. I can't believe it. She shot down my best pickup line. Are girls worth this much trouble? If I don't get 12 new subscriptions, I won't get to be Paperboy of the Month. I really hate being a paperboy. Did you hear that some of the villagers want to make this into a resort? Shoot, why didn't I think of doing something like that? Now that you've killed the beast, I have the chance to turn my dream into reality. The girl that has stolen my heart will finally be mine. She's hoping for a spring wedding. I want to make her dream a reality too. I'm told that the marriage will be this spring. I just can't wait. Ruby says, I'm guessing spring might have come already for you two. Look a little too rosy, if you ask me. And then this is the way out. But I'm not sure it's down this way. So I'm going back to the ship. We still gotta get Leo, which is gonna be difficult. Because I think we have to go through the Mystic Ruins backwards. And I'm not sure how to do that. Now, I'm not sure. Is it down there? Oh, it's here. We're not gonna be able to get a. Oh, we are, okay. Yeah, let's see what they have to say. Dear sweet Galleon has not been here for many months. I wonder why he neglects the beautiful garden he created. I even finished the task he assigned me. Now his ABBA records lie silently in alphabetical order, waiting for his appreciative ear. Ruby says, since you don't have Galleon around here anymore, I'll ask Gnarl to guard you. He'll probably have the blue and black dragons look out for you, too. If you're lucky, maybe they'll torch the LPs, too. So cheer up, okay? So the strange girl that was with you disappeared like Master Galleon. How heartbreaking. No comment. This way. Galleon was resurrected by the power of Zophar. Therefore, he could neither seal nor destroy Zophar by himself. I heard him talking about it the last time he was here. I was dreaming that I was controlled by a river filled with ones and zeros. It made no sense to me. Do you know what it means? Yeah, it's code. Are you going up into the mystic ruins? Funny, another person just went in ahead of you. If you hurry, you might catch him. That'd be Leo. Galleon was worried that a boy named Hero might fall in love with a girl he met. He said if that happened, this world would not stand a chance against Zophar. I wonder what he meant. Hero said Galleon said that, but I'm sure he'd help Lucia. Galleon deceived Zophar into thinking he was on Zophar's side. Galleon knew all along that human power could defeat Zophar. His ruse saved this world. Now he can stop tormenting himself with guilt. I wonder where he is. You came from outside the ruins. Have you seen dear Galleon anywhere? He hasn't been here for, so long, and we're starting to worry. Okay, this is the part that screws me up. And I'm gonna have to make notes. And I'm going to have to, report back my findings and show you guys how to get through here, because someone watching might want to know. So, thanks for watching. See you next episode when we get Leo, and bang, bang, boogie, and don't stop the boogie.